Nigeria may not survive consequences of Nnamdi Kanu's rotting in detention. Family wants. That is the news headline. You're welcome to this news. Please listen to the news details carefully. And don't forget that you can share your view with us. The family of the detained leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, Nnamdi Kanu, has urged President Muhammadu Buhari to heed the pleas by Igbo leaders and release their son. A group under the aegis of highly respected Igbo greats, led by First Republic parliamentarian and Minister of Aviation, Chief Umbazolu Ike Amichi, had visited Buhari on Friday and demanded the release of the IPOB leader. Reacting, Kanu's younger brother, Prince Emmanuel Kanu, said that the president should consider the request by the eminent Igbo elders as a mark of respect for the Igbo nation. He said that one of the ways to kickstart the process of national healing is the unconditional release of Kanu. Prince Emmanuel expressed hope that Buhari would give urgent attention to the pleas of the elders. Adding his voice, Kanu's first cousin, Mr. Shijindu Ofor, urged the president not to throw away the passionate appeal by the elders, who represent the entire Igbo race. Ofor said that the immediate and unconditional release of Kanu had become necessary because of his deteriorating health. He raised fresh concern over Kanu's health and safety following the alarm by Kanu's lawyers on Thursday that he was subjected to harsh, degrading and inhuman conditions in detention. Ofor said that Kanu should not be allowed to die in detention or be incapacitated, warning that Nigeria might not be able to contain the aftermath of any such eventualities. I appeal to the federal government to listen to the voice of wisdom and allow my cousin, Nnamdi Kanu, to go home so he can attend to his failing health. Nigeria may not survive the fallout of anything until what happened to my cousin. So why not save the country such needless pains, he said. The families of the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, had warned the president of Nigeria to listen to the pleas of the great Igbo leaders that came visiting at the Aso Rock Villa on Friday, demanding for the release of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally and towards his unfailing health. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who has been complaining about his health, that he should be released unconditionally and immediately, because if anything happens to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu in the detention, Nigeria will not be able to survive the fallout of anything untoward happening. So instead of allowing the country to face some pains, instead of Nigeria containing some aftermath of any such eventualities, the president should save the country such needless pains. That Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, nothing must happen to him, because Nigeria will not be able to contain whatever will happen. And this is coming in when the ACF addresses Owanaze, says IPOB leader must answer for his crimes against Nigeria. The Arewa Consultative Forum ACF has criticized the leadership of the Obanase Indubo for the unconditional release of the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Let us recall that the main Igbo sociocultural group had met with President Muhammadu Buhari, demanding the unconditional release of Mr. Kanu as a way to address the security situation in the entire southeastern region. But the northern group rejected the idea, saying Kanu would be above the law if unconditionally released without facing trial on the terrorism-related charges against him. ACF National Advertising Secretary Emmanuel Yeo, in a statement on Monday, said that anybody accused of committing a serious crime against the state must be able to stand up to the law. He said, "Why should the executive release someone charged with serious crimes against the state because their tribal organization has demanded it? If we start doing that, there will be no more rule of law in Nigeria again. If there is no rule of law, there is no democracy. If the man is convicted, we will understand if there is a petition to the president to grant him a pardon through a prerogative of clemency as established in the constitution. We do not agree that a person accused of serious crimes against the state of the kind that this Nnamdi Kanu is charged with should be released. It seems that Obanase Indubo has always supported their activities, some of which have cost many lives, including those of the security officers. If they are not against his alleged crimes, why demand for his pardon? Why demand his release without going through due process of law? Is it above the law of the land? Those people are against the saying of President Muhammadu Buhari. When the Igbo group came to visit him, he said, "The demand is very heavy, but he's going to consider it." And ever since then, a lot of groups have been coming up telling the president not to release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. He must face the consequences of whatever he has done. He must be prosecuted and punished. Because if it is not prosecuted and punished, that means there is no rule in Nigeria again. The rule of law have been destroyed. So, whatever the president wants to do, he should not release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Thank you once again for tuning in. Enjoy the rest of your day.